Okay, so in this video, I'm going to quickly state the general precedence rule to figure out what to differentiate and what to integrate when using integration by parts. Remember, the problem is I have something written as a product of two functions. I have to figure out which is the part to differentiate, which is the part to integrate. The precedence rule, the general precedence rule, is sometimes called ILATE. Sometimes it's also called LIATE. You may have seen it in that form, but they're actually the same rule. It says that inverse trig and logarithmic functions, which are I and L, are the ones you really prefer to differentiate. Algebraic functions, which is the A, which includes polynomial functions, rational functions, and radical expressions, are in between. And trigonometric and exponential functions are the ones you most prefer trigonometric and exponential.
You want to integrate that.
You want to integrate them. Okay. So if you have a product which involves something here and something here, you can use this idea to figure out which to differentiate, which to integrate. If integration by parts works, then it will usually work based on this rule. So this, if you follow this rule and the problem is meant to be solved by integration by parts, it will usually work. There are some subtleties. But let me just quickly explain. I won't go into the full details. I'll quickly explain how this rule that follows from the general picture here, where you figure out for each function type how it differentiates, how it integrates. Okay? So inverse trig and log, which are up here, when you differentiate, you move into the algebraic domain and you don't even try to integrate. Okay? Because it's terrible. And that's why you put them on the differentiate side. Because when you do differentiate them, they move somewhat nicer to algebraic things, which can be integrated. And the reason it's important that the thing you get after differentiation comes in an integration domain is because in integration by parts, there's a second integration you need to do. Right? After doing the integration by parts, you have to solve a second integration. So these things, when you differentiate, they get simpler, and that's why you pick these as the part to differentiate, if you have a choice. Now, what about algebraic? Well, the polynomials, you can differentiate and you can integrate. So when you are competing against inverse and log, which you cannot integrate by any formula, then it makes sense to pick the polynomial as the part to integrate. Because the log and inverse will get into the algebraic domain, and the log inverse you differentiate polynomials. That's why it's below inverse and log. Or rather, it's more on the integrate side than inverse and log. On the other hand, if it's competing with a trigonometric or exponential, then the polynomial, when you differentiate, what happens to it? Complexity, the degree goes down by one, and eventually the polynomial becomes zero, which means that when it's competing with the trig or exp thing, then the polynomial is something which you want to differentiate because complexity goes down. Okay, whereas for trig and exponential, whether you differentiate or integrate, the complexity doesn't change. The sine, cosine, exponential, hyperbolic cosine. When you differentiate, it remains similar, and integrate remains similar. So these are functions which you prefer to integrate because all the other ones do get simpler when you differentiate, and these don't care. Okay? Now, there's a little issue here with these other two classes of functions, which are algebraic non-polynomial, like rational function, trigonometric, and exponential. When you see some of these, the trigonometric and exponential rational functions like tan, secant, cotangent, cosecant, or you see these algebraic non-polynomial like rational functions, then it's a little less clear what to do. Generally speaking, you should still follow the same precedence rule. So even the non-polynomial algebraic ones come in the middle, and the non-polynomial, that is these rational function types trigonometric, come here. But it may often happen that you are ultimately not able to do the problem using integration by parts. You get stuck somewhere. So that could happen. And the reason is that unlike the polynomials, these types of algebraic functions, you can keep differentiating. They don't eventually become zero. Okay? And when you integrate these types of algebraic functions, you may go outside the algebraic domain to the inverse trig or log. Similarly, for the trigonometric and exponential, when you differentiate, you do stay within trig and exponential, but it's not really staying equally complex. It could get more messy. And when you integrate trigonometric and exponential, you can get really messy things like down here. The tan gets a negative log cosine. So this is a very quick explanation of the precedence rule. Now the important thing is inverse and log, there's no real precedence between them. Trigonometric and exponential, there's no real precedence between them. So some people write it as I-late, some people write it as lie-late. It's up to you. But however, it may still help to keep a precedence between trig and exponential to basically to avoid the circular trap. And we'll see that in an actual example.